Yeah. Sean Q. Dip. I appreciate you, baby. Yeah. Now we know love is all about choices. A little cuddling and race horses. Cause that's just how we do when it's me and you. Now we on the couch with Rich Sean Q. We gon' spark it up if I spark is out. No more walking out cause we gon' talk it out. Now we gon' work it out cause that's what love's about. Me and you, that's what my life's about. Now them late nights when we on the couch. Rich Sean Q, we gon' joke a lot. We gon' laugh a lot. We gon' talk about everything that we done been through just about. Yeah, no more bad choices, race horses. I got champagne and white orchids. Right now, but it's me and you. With Sasha J and Sean Q. Yeah.
Tune to Couch Talk. It's your boy Sean Q, and today we have a lovely, the beautiful Miss Iyshaa Wilks. How you doing, mama?
Good. How you doing?
I'm great. I'm great. Always feeling lovely. You know, you might have to refresh that joint, but I'm out of computer.
Right.
But listen, thank you.
You're welcome. Definitely.
Like, no, I just want thank you. You don't understand what I mean. Like, you put me at a level that I wasn't there before. So when somebody make you level up, like, that's big. That's big. That mean a lot to me.
Definitely. That's what I'm supposed to do.
And I really appreciate you. Whatever it takes. Whatever it takes. I told you don't do that. Don't be looking around. I need you to be with me.
I got you. I'm here. Got you.
Okay. So let's talk about whatever it takes. Let's just dive right into it. So we don't beat around the bush. Scared to eat pussy, so you look around too. You remember?
Yeah.
Okay. Whatever it takes. So, when did you feel? Cause I read the book, amazing book. It took me through. Cause I knew you before.
Yeah.
But the book took me through a journey that I didn't know about in its totality.
Yes.
I knew bits and pieces, but I never knew the entire story.
Right.
And it made me look at you in a whole different light. So before I tell you my thoughts on it, I want
to
know.
I was just about to ask.
Nah. This ain't about me. Before I tell you my thoughts on it, I want to know, like, the process of writing the book and how deep was those, feelings when you was going. Because you exposed a lot about yourself.
Yes. The process of it, you have to get deep.
Yeah.
You have to be very authentic and very true to yourself. So the process for me was just really getting alone by myself, no outside influence, nobody else in my ear, nobody else talking, and really like going back, putting myself in that same moment to feel exactly how I felt at that moment in time to write it out.
Yeah, that's deep, though.
And go there, you know?
Putting yourself in the moments, like you dealt with addiction issues, you dealt with, I ain't gonna say homelessness issues, but to some that would feel like that, not having your own, growing up and living in different places and stuff, as the book exposed. But you can't get the book on Amazon. I'm gonna throw that out. Damn, my elbow's ashy. Why didn't you tell me my elbow's ashy?
You always ashy.
Anyway, get Bay, cause she you can lay in there.
Right.
She ukulele in there.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. So what's going on? Like it's a. You're fixing the lights. One of us was a little too light skinned. And I want all my melanin to pop. So I appreciate the lighting fixing. As we were going.
Right.
I don't want to get you off task because we was going deep into it. And
right.
So just the back into going into the moments, like where did it take you?
It really took me to, and that's something that I would say when you're telling your story, you have to be ready to tell your story. It's not just you going back to say, oh yeah, this happened, and that happened. No, you got to be prepared for it because it's also a part of self-healing. Because as I went back and wrote the story, being the woman that I am today and where I am today, I saw things in a different light. But it was so important to go back and feel exactly how I felt at that time and write exactly how I felt at that time to relate to people who were going through something similar. Because right now, I don't feel the exact same way. But the way I felt at that time has had an effect on me. It made me who I am today.
Okay. So what do you feel was your rock bottom or your turning point where you felt like you had to do whatever it took to get you out of that position?
I would say depression. Yeah.
That was after everything was completed. You went through a lot.
Right. But see, the thing is, it's like when people say I have taken all I can take, that's at that rock bottom. Because you, even the strongest people, we can go through so much, and we all come to a breaking point. You know,
yeah.
It's like you gonna fold, or you gonna keep rolling with the punches. You know, so being depressed is kind of like, after being strong for so long, you get to a point you're like, I'm tired. You know, you get depressed, and then a lot goes through your mind during those stages. Because I've seen a lot of posts and a lot of people saying depression is real. It is real, but it's just like another emotion, so to speak. You cannot let it linger.
Thanks.
You can't sit in it. You know, you sit in it to feel it, but a part of healing and a part of growing and a part of moving forward, you gotta let that pass through, and you gotta come up out of it. But for me, that was rock bottom.
Okay, so completely not what I thought you was gonna say.
What you thought I was gonna say?
No, because I went through, because honestly, that question, I wrote that question before I read the book.
Okay.
Because I knew you told me it was a journey for you. So I really wanted to know what was that bottom point that made you turn up. Because I hit one myself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I care not to go deep into mine right now. We talking about you.
I was about to ask.
Now we talking about you. No, and you know, I can tell you what mine was. And mine was more of a financial thing. Because
okay.
I felt like at this age in life, I shouldn't be right here. I should be doing way more than what I'm doing. I'm way smarter than this. I'm way more talented than this. Why am I in this position?
Right.
And for me, it was just wasting time. I wasted a lot of time doing frivolous shit that it really didn't amount to anything.
Okay.
And it wasn't that I was out doing a whole bunch of dumb, crazy shit, but it was just stuff that wasn't amounting to nothing.
Right.
And, you know, it's almost like that my homeboy standing on the block mentality. You can leave your city for millions of years and come back, and there's people that you knew probably going to be doing the same exact thing.
Same thing.
And that was just a fear of me just getting into a repetitive thought process.
Yeah. I can see that.
Yeah. So that was
but a lot of people think like that, and I really wish that people's thought process was different when it comes down to that, because the time that you spent, you could either look at it as wasted time, or you can look at it as time that you've learned something during that time. So it's not necessarily always wasted. I mean, true. What you're saying is true. You could have, you know, been doing something else, but it's not always a waste.
I'm
if you learn something.
I'm fucking off, that's all.
That's it.
I'm fucking off. But listen, okay, so Chester County, let's take it to the city, because I know our city is really hurting right now.
Yeah.
There's a lot of dumb gun violence going on in the city.
Right.
And that's why I feel like this interview came at the perfect time for me to speak what I thought about the mentality and the mindset of our city. Because
right.
you went through so much in that book, in your life. I mean, I read it in the book, but you went through so much in your life.
Right.
And still to have the wherewithal to come through all of that with your head held high, still kept your faith somewhat.
Yeah.
We'll talk about it. Still kept your faith. Not in God, just in the institution of religion.
Right.
But anyway, like I say, for another time, we're talking about the book right now.
Right.
So, how did your faith play a big role in everything?
You have to believe. You have to believe in the vision that you have, that you see in your mind, beyond what you see in the physical around you. You have to be passionate about it. You have to want it bad enough. You can't get comfortable. Like wake up and you're not happy with something, and I feel like this about everybody. When you wake up and you're not happy with something in your life, change. You got to do something to make it change. You cannot be comfortable. You can't get comfortable. A lot of people, they wake up and they're comfortable. This is their norm. You know, they complain about it and that's it. Like, if you're happy with it, don't complain about it.
You know, I literally take different routes everywhere I go.
Really?
Just so I don't get comfortable.
Just to change.
Yeah, just so I don't get comfortable in the same mindset of I'm doing this. I'm going to go here. I know I'm going to be here. I don't want to be predictable to myself. I stopped getting off work and coming straight home.
Right.
Because it was like work, home, work, home, work, home. Just the same repetitive thing. Like, if I had to just stop at the store and just walk around that bitch and not buy nothing, I did that just to get off that route of work, home, work, home, work, home. It helped a lot. It really did, because it opened my mind up. Because even just walking in Walmart or walking in the convenience store, I started seeing stuff. stuff that was funny to me. And I started writing skits and shit. So it helped the creative process and everything that I had going on. But I want to, like I said, we got off Chester for a minute. Like, I want to rest in peace, Andrew Johnson. Man, Scrap, you know, East Chester, all that. It's tatted on my stomach. So East Chester is really hurting right now.
Right.
Rest in peace, Scrap. Like, it's just a lot of senseless violence going on. So we really have to step up and do something to try to help our city out. Jody Bean Rambert got Project Peace coming up.
Yes.
We're gonna play a video from what they got going on. Big Ren on the engineering tip. Big Ren, go and run that Project Peace for us one time, man. We'll come back and talk about it.
Yeah, it's the lack of knowledge, knowing the outcome of a situation, or not knowing what destination you're going to. What's gonna happen? That's all it is. The more you educate yourself, you maximize your potential.
I was raised different. Had a pops in the yard, a mama in the kitchen. Still, I found the trenches. They said, son, you lose your life by just trying to live it. Helen Keller, I couldn't see it and didn't listen. I've been giving the story straight, you just got it twisted. The version you regurgitate excludes all suspicions. You lanes tried to make a point, oh, sorry, I missed it. Beefing with broke, like writing with broken pencils. There's no point, and I'm too short. My future look bright, but the sum I'm just... Care for us, I'm for Confederate flags hanging outside the residence. But wait, it's not hate, they calling the heritage. Style is not the one of their skin. You lose your life, I lose my freedom, so who really wins? They ain't gotta hang us no more, they got caught. Watered down our educations, then they gave us sports. Cameras and mics in our faces like they gave us a voice. Soon as we speak on the issues, they don't wanna record. I miss the old days, still stuck in my old ways. Secrets in
What's up? What up? What up? What up? Yeah, listen, that's that Project Peace, man. That's what my brother's got going on down there in Chester, South Carolina. Yeah, I'm stupid. But that's what my people got going on down there. They really trying to help the community, because right now it's almost to a point where the adults are just, there's no helping the adults at this point. Like, we really got to help the youth. We really have to start right there and get the youth involved in something else besides fucking, drinking, smoking, and just hanging out. Smoking them tweets. Like, nah, I'm just saying, like, it just has to be more that we can do. So if you are old enough, if you, like I was saying on my live the other day, if you are OG, if you're anybody, what is that noise? Oh, okay. Air. Listen, if you're OG or you anybody that got any influence over anybody,
right,
like, do something. Like, if it ain't nothing just to go pick them up, to take them riding with you, talk to them for a little bit. Boxing programs, like what my man got going on. Like, it's just so much more that we can do. Me, myself, I have to do more. I don't know how the rest of the room feel, but I just feel like we all have to do more to help our youth.
Yes, and the thing is that Project Peace meets at the library. And my thing is, when people set up something, when we set something up for you to bring the youth out, we're setting it up for you. All you got to do is bring them. All you got to do is come. And speaking on behalf of Project Peace, I mean, for men, like, bring your sons, bring your nephews, bring any of those young boys that you see down the street. It's beneficial to grown men as well. I mean, that's how good it is. And they teach about things that these boys ain't going to learn in school.
Thanks.
You know, they're not going to learn in school. And it's things that they need to learn. I don't know who made it cool to be dumb and do dumb stuff.
You know what?
Like, I don't know who made it cool.
Can I get off topic for a second?
Yeah.
Like, they blamed Urkel in an article that I read.
This Urkel who?
Urkel, like the fucking TV show Urkel. Steve Urkel.
What?
They blamed Steve Urkel for, listen, they blamed Steve Urkel for the fall of the black man, because they put
How?
Steve, listen, they were saying they put Steve Urkel in front of us on TV every night. And we saw he couldn't get the girl. He was a nerd. He was super smart, but he wasn't getting the girl. He wasn't getting nothing. He was always getting messed up. So when little kids see that at a young age, they don't want to become that nerd. They don't want to become that type of guy, because it's not going to get the girl, and it's not going to make them cool.
So
that was just an article I read.
Would you say that Steve Urkel had an effect on you.
Yeah, because I was skinny.
Really?
And I used to wear glasses.
Come nah, on now.
Nah, but listen, on some G-shit, listen, peep. And I always said,
hey, but who he turned into?
Stephon, and that's my thing.
How did he turn into Stephon? Stephon couldn't turn into nobody. Stephon ain't had that to turn
that's
into nobody.
That's facts.
I'm just talking about the article. These are not my words.
But I'm just saying.
It's an article.
You
but this is the thing.
Deeper into it.
I always said, I bet you won't give me that.
Let me see that. Let me get this camera. Let me get her solo.
So this is what my man said he was looking like. Wait, come on, where you at? Okay, this
right.
This is what my man said he was looking like, yo, back in the day.
He's a clown.
Urkel. We got Urkel in the house.
All the time.
Oh, shit. But anyway, yo, now I'm going to get off of you. But nah, like back to Chelsea. But that was just an article I read.
Right,
you know,
right.
Side note.
Right.
Back to Chelsea. So Project Peace.
Yes.
And you said who made it cool to be
who
dumb.
Who made it cool to be dumb? Like, that ain't cool.
No.
You know what I'm saying? It's not cool. It's one thing when you actually don't know, but it's another thing when you don't know and you ain't even trying to find out. You're not trying to learn. You're not trying to apply yourself. And I feel like as grown men, something should move a man to see a younger man growing up without guidance to be there for him or do something for him. Even if you don't know what to do or you don't know how to show him, the fact that you know that Project Peace even exists, it ought to make you say, hey, let's go here.
Take my son.
Yeah, my let's listen, go here.
Take my son. I see you know more than what. And it's okay to say I don't know. A saying that I've been saying for like the past 7 years, it's better to know what you don't know than not know what you do know.
Right.
And I'm going to let that marinate for a couple people. It's better to know what you don't know than not know what you do know. Basically, that means if you don't know how to be that type of father, don't pretend to be and lead your son in a direction that you know is not right just because that's all you know.
And it's
that's
not some, an excuse to say, well, I ain't know.
Yeah, and that's something
it's
I'm
not
having
an excuse.
To learn. Because that's something I'm having to learn. Because I grew up in East Chester where my homeboy just got murdered. And it's crazy because the mentality ain't changed. The mentality literally ain't changed. Like, when I was 12 years old, I had a pistol. Little young, dumb nigga with a pistol. An older person took the pistol from me. We wrestling over the motherfucker. So, just so happened, all the bullets fell out the revolver. The nigga picked that bitch up and click. I'm 12 years old, and that happened to me. And just a few weeks later, a few weeks ago, I hear my nephew had a gun pulled out on him.
Right.
And he's around the same age. So that lets me know the cycle and the mentality of the people around there has not changed.
No, but you know what's even worse is the fact that it's normal. It should not be normal.
Because I didn't cry. There was not a tear shed.
Right.
There was not a moment where I sat back like, damn, I wasn't even supposed to be here right now.
Something that would have shook somebody else.
Yeah, that's normal.
It's like,
And that's
It should not be the norm. And that's the major problem. Like, it should be the norm. And my thing is, when things happen like that, like, people go back to their day-to-day life like ain't nothing happened. Like, we don't have a problem.
Brush it off.
Yeah. Everything goes back to normal until it happens again. And then it's like, oh, everybody want to make a big fuss about it. Everybody want to say this and say that about it. But no, what are you doing every day to change it or to prevent it from happening again? You know, what are you doing to be proactive about the situation instead of saying, oh, this happened and everybody blow up? Like, get in front of it. Get in front of it. You ought to be tired. We ought to be tired. As people, we ought to be tired.
And we're not, because people got shot after that. Two more people were shot after that.
Right.
And it's like to the point, like, where does it stop?
Right.
And I'm tired of asking where does it stop. So that's why Project Peace is a good thing.
Right.
That's something we all can invest in. We all got kids. We all know kids. Like, send them there.
Mm-hmm.
It's not boring to be a man. It's not boring to do the right thing.
Right.
Like, I hate harping back to my nephew, but he got God-given talent to literally take himself to a different stratosphere.
Right.
But the streets of Chester, South Carolina are literally sucking all that energy out of him.
He needs the right environment. If he's in the right environment, that's just like, it's like planting seeds. You can plant many different seeds. You can hold seeds in your hand right now. If you're not an expert, all you know is they are seeds. You don't know if it's a seed for a flower. You don't know if it's a seed for a tree. You don't know if it's a seed that's going to produce some kind of fruit or vegetable. You don't know that, you know. But once you put them in the ground, once you put them in the right environment, once you water those seeds, they're going to grow. and you're going to know whether they're going to produce fruit or whether they're going to be a flower or whatever.
It's the
same thing with children. They need the right environment to grow in. You don't change who they are. You don't make them be who you want them to be. Your job, our job, is to create that environment for them to thrive in and for them to grow to their highest potential. Shout out to Mr. P2P.
Facts. Hey, Trez. Hey, listen.
Trez.
Trez inspired me. Me and Trez went on a lunch. I don't say a lunch date, but we met out for lunch one day, man. And I'm just talking to Trez, and he wrestled with me, so I'm thinking Trez from who I knew.
Right.
Man, that man done transformed himself into a god. Like, it's crazy. He breathed life into me when we went out.
Yeah.
Like, I was looking at him like, huh?
And he would be wrong to not do it. Because of who the man he is now, he got to show you that he different. You know what I'm saying? You gotta walk and talk that. You can't. A lot of people act like, I ain't fake. You know what I'm saying? People going to think I'm fake if I show up like this. So they want to kind of bring it down to who they used to be and present their image in front of you like, oh, I'm still cool. Go back to that cool thing, you know, trying to be cool. That ain't cool. You need to be who you are. You need to stand in it and walk in it. Don't dumb it down. Don't bring it down, because by you being yourself, you show everybody else this is who we are. We ain't that dumb stuff.
We not.
This is who we are.
I tell my daughter.
So you show up wherever you go, you show up.
Nerds are cool now. Like, nerds are the coolest shit ever. Like, I'm mad I got off my nerd pad. I'm trying to get back on it.
Nerds always been cool.
Okay, no, they weren't. Urkel changed that. Urkel changed that.
Look, Urkel reffing now. Listen,
and you know, to the point of that, I put my turtle bottle up just to show nerds are cool. I'm a fucking Ninja Turtle fan. You know what I mean? Ninja Turtles, baby. I can be an adult and still love the turtles. All right? That's all I'm saying. Nerds are cool now. Like, be who you are and don't let anybody change that. If you love the turtles, your birthday, get you a fucking turtle bottle. Bedazzle, bitch.
Bedazzle.
Get that motherfucker. Ooh. And Remy. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. That bottle hard. Don't touch that thing one time.
Yeah, that's hard.
That thing hard. Look at that. Don't knock my shit off.
Custom
now.
Made or custom. You found it?
No, it's custom made. It's custom made.
Man, you got a custom made Ninja
Listen, if you're Candy, Miss Godbody Evans. Okay. Look her up on Facebook and Instagram.
It looks good.
Candy Miss Godbody Evans. She made this for me. That shit hard.
Now, if Sean ain't scared to show his Ninja Turtle bottle,
yes,
y'all don't be scared to be.
You better not open my shit. Nigga.
But speaking on Chester, one thing that I wonder about, it's like, let's dig deeper, because we can say all day, and this with me and anybody else who try to do something for the youth or try to speak positivity to our people, let's dig deeper to the root of it. Like, why? Why are we so angry? Why are we out here doing stuff that, you know, it's not beneficial. It doesn't help us. It only sets us back further. Like, why are we doing that?
I have some thoughts on it. And for me, I'm a little older. 88 was when I was born. Fuck y'all if y'all call me old. Shut up. Oh, my fault. I thought you said something different. 88 was when I was born. So I grew up in the Springs era, when Springs was a plant. Both of them was in Chester.
Right.
Both of my parents worked. My mom and my grandma worked there.
Right.
And we thrived, but we wasn't hurting for shit when they worked at Springs.
Right.
And pretty much that was most of Chester County. When them two left, Chester turned into the real hood. It was hood a little bit, but when Springs left, the income was gone for the parents. Hey, I'm gonna need y'all to calm down in there. The income was gone for the parents. So don't y'all laugh. I'm trying to keep it going. If y'all laugh, I'ma laugh. I can only y'all laugh. All right. But yeah, the income was gone for the parents when Springs left. So with that, with the parents having to struggle and strive, now the kids see they growing up, see their parents struggling.
Right.
So now we got to find another way to make money. And unfortunately, if you can't find a job, how the hell I'm going to find a job?
Right.
Went to the streets. And them streets is violent.
Yeah.
Regardless. And that's how most ghettos, that's how most projects are made. Think about Detroit when they had the Ford factories up there.
Right.
When the Ford factories left, Detroit became that murder capital that it is. I ain't going to say right now because I ain't from there, but it became that.
Yeah.
When the jobs left. So we can put up projects for these kids to do, but it has to be some type of cash flow coming into the city some type of way
for those programs to work. Right. And it takes all the parents and everybody to invest into it. It I has understand. To be invest
but
in your kids.
Speaking of investing, they gotta have money or the time to invest in it. You see what I'm saying? So it's like, how do you come from that? And my thing is, it's so much deeper than just jobs not being in Chester. And I say that because we have to get in a position to where we can create them.
Big facts.
And that's not too far from, it should not be far from our minds. Like, people cannot even fathom that. When we get a good job, we're like, oh, I got a good job.
No.
When we go to school, it's like, oh, I done graduated. Now, don't get me wrong. Those are good things and those are accomplishments. I believe in celebrating every single accomplishment, no matter how big or how small. But we have to think bigger. We can't sit and complain about something and do nothing to change it. And it can't be so far from our minds that we feel like we can't create it for ourselves. Instead of, you know, just saying, okay, I'm going to go get out here and find a job. Is anybody thinking, I'm going to create jobs?
And that's what's crazy. So, when you came here, you was like, I didn't know this was how it was set up and everything.
Right.
Like, this is literally a job.
Yes.
I ain't going to give it to no grown-ass man. I promise you I'm not. I'm not going to give it to no grown-ass man. It's my camera. My fault. I switched it up. Boom. I'm not going to give it to no grown-ass man. But if you got a child that's interested in media or something like that, like, inbox me.
Right.
Like, this is what I can do because this is what I know how to do. I can teach them multimedia. I can teach them how to record a podcast because podcasts is booming. They make money now.
Right.
And that's the way you can keep your child in the house. And that's the way you can keep your child out of these streets doing dumb stuff because you can make money from home now.
Right.
Like, you don't have to be in the streets. Like, these nerds that y'all think are not cool no more, like, they literally making six figures from their house on their computer.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to figure it out. Because I'm tired of struggling.
And see, even what you're doing right here can be intimidating. It's like where we come from and how we grew up. You know how you say, you know, being on the block or whatever. Like, it's some boys right now that be on the block. But in what you, them seeing what you do, they come up in here, man, they will look at it and get intimidated. And be like, I can't do this. I can't, like, step one, stop saying what you can't do.
Big facts.
Even if you got to take little bits and pieces. Take a little bit at a time. If you learn one thing a day, that's 365 days in a year. If you learn one thing a day, that's 365 things you don't learn in a year. So, I mean, you know, you can't say what you can't do, you know? I say anything is possible. I said in my book, anything is possible.
I want to talk about your book, because I want to talk about when Ayana came, because that was a shocker for me. I'm going to be honest with you. But right now, I want to get into a video.
Okay.
The video, my homeboy Joey Vandal. Matter of fact, go to the Couch Talk page for a second. I got you. We'll be back shortly.
I ain't never stunting no niggas. I ain't really hunting these hoes. Running with some wool D rolls. 50 pointers on me, check the score. Bag out of city, yeah. Had to put the check on roll. Whip running like Diddy and Mace. I make the motor haul of shape. Like a personal trainer. I made your aunt touch a toe. Said she had me a plate. But first I had to smoke this bowl. Split a finger to the cops. Keep a finger on the Glock. Cause when you really show love, they have hate in their heart. You rap niggas should stop. You ain't holding no knot. Let the camera zoom in. Them ain't hundreds, them props. I guess fake it till you make it. As for me, I'm straight. If you rap in this game, it could be a lot at stake. Broken watch, I don't have the time. I do life if being me was a grind. Say you love me, but I know you lying. Say to myself, I'm steady peeping out the blind. Didn't need a blimp to tell me the world's mine. So give me mine. Need a blimp to tell me the world's mine. Nothing's given how I'm living, so I grind. I went to sleep on some new guap, tryna make it stretch like a two-top. You know I'm a ball, Tupac. All eyes on me when they see the VVs. I'm the man on the moon, smoking moon rock. And I gotta stay alert, been posting up like dirt. With this Mark Cuban on my shirt. Playing my role like Denzel, make a nigga sick, get a ginger ale. You can't prevail, you tell the tale. You got in tune and gave intel. But I'm too intelligent for irrelevance. You on the curb, I'm so ahead of it. Lit on my wrist, Thomas Edison. Sipping raw cup, unedited. Gave the fake, no time of day. Like the bell ring, and no time to play. Stay to myself, that's how I stay. No need worrying about where I stay. I'm real like Tony, I'm waiting on your army. As long as it's on me, then I'm in Milani. Most of real niggas hella phony. No small talk for your big homie. Broken watch, I don't have the time. I do life if being me was a crime. Say you love me, but I know you lying. Say to myself, I'm steady peeping out the blind. Didn't need a blimp to tell me the world's mine. So give me mine. Didn't need a blimp to tell me the world's mine. Nothing's given how I'm living, so I grind.
My dog. We ready? Let's bring the show back. Yo, what up? We back. So yeah, let's get back into it, because I love the conversation we're having. This is what I needed. This is interesting. So, in the book you talked about when you got pregnant with Ayan.
Uh-huh.
Am I saying the name right? Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I hate, you know, Sean Quavius. I hate having people names and
I
stuff.
I know, right?
Shut up. That wasn't even you weren't supposed to laugh. Anyway, so the thought process of almost not being a mother,
mm-hmm.
almost not having your daughter, almost thinking about abortion,
right.
What was that process for you?
I am going to be very open, honest, and transparent, because when I speak, I don't speak just for myself.
Yeah.
And I'm very aware of that. I speak for every young girl, every woman who's ever, you know, been pregnant, you know, mm-hmm. especially young girls. And I'm going to say this, and a lot of people may not agree with the situation. I do not condone it, you know. I don't agree with it. But the reality of the situation is things happen.
Mm-hmm.
The worst thing we can do is talk down to our young women and to our young girls. That's the worst thing you can do, you know, because it's such a sacred thing when you are bringing life into this world. And as a young girl, it's a lot of things that they do not understand. They don't. And the first thing is, you know, people talking bad to you, talking down on you. So you have, you know, people who don't know you
mm-hmm.
Looking at you in a negative way. You have your family looking at you in a negative way. You have people, you know, just around you giving off these negative vibes and energy. Like, and you already feel, you don't know how to feel yourself. You know, so it's heavy. It's real heavy when it's really a sacred thing. very sacred. And you really, at that time, is when you really need your women to surround you and to shower you with love and support. And we don't get that, you know?
Who is we?
We as women.
Okay.
And young girls, they don't get that, you know? If you do, you are blessed. You know, you are blessed to get it. But it's, you know, and I think that's why a lot of women and a lot of young girls do go through with the process, you know, because of all of the pressure. And a lot of times people in your ear telling you, well, you can't do this and you can't do that. Your life is going to be this way and your life is going to be that way, which is so unfair, you know?
Okay, that's true. So you went all the way up to the point of the day of when you were about to have your abortion.
Mm-hmm.
So first of all, what made you say, okay, I'm going to have an abortion? Mm-hmm. And then second to that, what made you, that day, what was the catalyst that made you say, nah, I'm not going to do it?
What made me think about it was the pressure and everybody else's expectations of me. And, you know, wondering what they were going to think. But inside, I always knew. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I always knew that. It was just the pressure of it. Of them knowing, of them saying this and saying that. It was like, okay, well, I'm going to do this because it's what everybody is saying.
Yeah.
But inside, I always knew that. So when it came down to the wire, it was like, nah. You know, you got to live with that decision. Okay. And it's kind of like those mother instincts will kick in.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And you just be like, no. You got to do it. And it's not easy for a lot of women or a lot of young girls to do that. To make that decision to say, well, no, I'm not going to go through with it.
Do you see a thing happening to you in life to where you say, yeah, I will have an abortion? Do you see any instance in life to where you think you could?
Not me personally. But, like I said, I don't speak for just myself.
Mm-hmm.
I do know of a lot of women who, you know, they choose to go through with that process. I don't agree. But mm-hmm. as a woman, I respect another woman's decision because, for one, it's her body.
Facts.
So whether I think it's wrong or right, it's her body. It's her decision, period. And, you know, they have their reason. They have their reason for it. I don't agree with it, but they have their reason. And at the end of the day, it's their decision, and they have to live with it.
Because you know
that
there are laws being passed
for
women having abortions. Like, some of the lower southern states are making it to the point where you're going to jail.
Yeah.
If you have an abortion.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not a woman, but I've had a woman pregnant, and she's had an abortion. Matter of fact, I had about two.
Okay.
Possible three. Listen, I was a wild boy.
It's reality.
Yeah, it's reality, but listen, it's a possible three. I just don't think that one was pregnant. I just don't think she was pregnant.
But might not have been.
Yeah, it might not have been, but I don't know if she was all. I think she just took my money and, you know, did her thing. But I know I had two for sure.
Right.
But at the end of the day, I didn't have a decision in that. Because the first one, we argued. Like, do not kill my baby. Like, that's not. And then she just stopped talking to me and I started talking to her family.
Right.
And I was like, yo, don't kill my. That's I want it.
Yeah.
And they was steady telling me, you don't know what you want. You're 18 right now. Like, I got her pregnant at senior week at the beach.
Yeah.
Senior week. And, like, you don't know what the fuck you want.
Right.
You have your whole life ahead of you. And so does my little sister. So does my daughter. So does my niece. Like, so does my cousin.
Mm-hmm.
She has her whole life ahead of her. So it's not to the point where you're making this decision. We're making this decision.
Right.
Because it's what's best for the family. Like, I don't know. Like, honestly, communication between me and her broke down after that. I ain't talked to her till like, years later.
Right.
Honestly, actually, I talked to her when these abortion laws first popped up, and I made a lot. I did a live about it. No, listen, and this has been what I graduated.
Like, why bring it back up though? Like,
listen, this is the thing, because we've never spoken, and she wasn't mad at what I said. She was like, I was always wondering how you felt about it. So we were just never the two to just come together and have the conversation.
Because it was other people involved.
Yeah, and we just lived. And when we finally, I ain't going to say sat down and talked, we had a few messages back and forth. It was like, oh, okay, that's how you felt. All right. Cool, because we both done moved on in life. So if we probably would have had that conversation years ago, it probably been a completely different one. You know, so it's just, if you got a dick, that's not your job to make that decision. I think Dave Chappelle said it on his new,
I mean, especially as women, we are the nurturers, you know? we give
the
birth.
Goddesses.
I'm not trying to, you know, push men at like men don't do anything as fathers or anything like that. But it's just natural. You know, it comes natural. We are the nurturers of our children. You know, they're with us majority of the time. You know, with the exception of the few men who do step into their lives, because every mother
ain't some mom, you know.
Yeah, they don't do what they're
supposed
to do. On what exactly?
On your upbringing, with you and your relationship with you and your mother.
Yeah, because I don't want to give the book away.
I understand.
Too much.
Okay, well, you don't have to.
You're not going to cop that.
On Amazon.
Yes.
You know, Amazon. The link will be in the comments.
You still got to go get that. So I'm not going to give too much
away. Put a book up on the screen. Put a book up. You know, you guys up there, just put a book up and let them know. Whatever it takes, it's on Amazon. Can they hit you up for copies?
Yes.
DM, we got
actually, the Sip 6, shout out to the Sip 6. I will be I have a vendor spot at their event coming up October 5th, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it's October 5th. And I will be there for signed copies. If you have not gotten your copy and you want a signed copy, yeah.
Oh, look, I got my copy. I'm gonna get my copy.
If you have not gotten your signed copy, meet me at that event.
I got my copy. Which camera we on? Which camera we on? Will got my copy. got my copy. It's a good read. It was a quick read. I will say that. It was a quick read, and I appreciate that because I'm not a reader. This was the first book I literally read in 15 years.
That's good.
15 plus.
And you know why? It's because when you start something, you need to finish it.
Dear Mama.
Yes.
Yeah, you talk a lot about Tupac in here.
Yeah.
And the Dear Mama song.
Yeah.
Like, what does that song say for you?
It symbolizes a lot. Just period. I'm not, and this is the thing that I want to say. I'm not the only one. I'm not the first. And I know I'm not going to be the last, which it would be nice in a perfect world if I was the last.
Mm-hmm.
But there are some people out there going through what I went through right now. You know, and that's real.
You got to tell us more what you went through. Like, what was the struggle? I know, don't give the book away.
Mm-hmm.
But outside of your own words, like tell us more.
One of the biggest things that's still real to this day is a dysfunctional family. That is one of the things that is very real to this day.
Environment.
Yeah, your environment, where you coming up in. I mean, it's like from a dysfunctional family. Dysfunctional families create dysfunctional communities. And so it's like it creates that crab in a bucket mentality. Crabs in a bucket mentality.
Yeah.
And a lot of people, it's something when you got strangers who really don't care for you, don't have a real reason to care for you. But you got family who, you know, don't want to see you do well.
Facts.
Or don't even care to invest the time that it takes to either teach you or show you, guide you in some way to becoming better. You know, a lot of people are about themselves. You know, they're inconsiderate when it comes down to us succeeding as a whole. You know, it's not just about me. It ain't just about you. And you know, people think that the world revolves around them, and it don't. And the family structure needs to be strengthened. It needs to be fixed.
Because we can talk about, I ain't completely vegetarian, vegan, none of that shit. But I don't cook meat in my house. Like, I literally try to eat it like once a week.
Right.
Like, for me, it started out with, I was eating it once a day.
Right.
And, you know, I'm already skinny as fuck, like, be honest with you.
Mm-hmm.
But it was just the ridicule from the family. Like, you gonna disappear? When you ain't no meat?
Right, you been skinny forever, though.
But facts, like, I'm literally, I graduated high school at 130. Right now, I'm 160.
Yeah.
I'm 160.
But you wrestled, though. Even
yeah, I wrestled, so I kept my weight down even then.
Yeah.
I had to. And I was fucking niggas up, too. Beast mode. Anyway. But it was just like, even trying to talk to my family about eating healthy, that was like, boy, you grew up on pork. Like, you grew up on this, you grew up on that, eat. I understand I grew up on it, but sometimes your mentality have to change.
Yeah.
Like, if I asked you right now, what do you eat for, taste or nutrition? The average person would tell me I eat for taste.
Exactly.
It has to taste good for me to eat it.
Right.
You can say both, but one's going to overpower the other. If it's nutritious, but it don't taste good, I promise you won't put it in your mouth.
That taste,
So listen, at the end of the day, if you're eating for taste, that's childish.
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm going to eat a piece of candy before I eat my food.
Mm-hmm.
That's what a little kid will say. Yeah. And he wants that candy. He will cry and fight. I want chocolate.
Yeah.
before he eat his dinner. Right. So you mean to tell me as a grown person, you willing to say, man, I want that good taste, but you know that good taste gonna give you diabetes. It's gonna give you cancer. It's gonna fuck you up.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, I'm looking at you because you standing, you sitting right fucking there. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm talking to you. I see myself on the camera. That's why I caught my shit. I look mean as shit talking to you too. I'm not talking to you, but I'm just saying, God. Like, if you're eating for taste, like, that's childish to me. I understand it has to taste good. It has to be digestible. Yes. I'm not saying just go eat out or go eat a bunch of nasty stuff. It has to be digestible.
So let me say, because when you say it's childish, I don't want anybody to get offended.
Fuck them.
My thing
that's
is,
you.
This is
fuck
me.
Fuck that. No, that's
Sean
stupid.
Don't care. I care.
You're grown.
Sean don't care.
You're a grown person. Like, I'm not saying just stop eating meat like me. I'm not saying do anything that I'm doing. But understand what you're doing to your fucking self by whatever you eating.
But it's an addiction. People don't realize the addiction.
Fact.
Like, okay, when you stopped eating meat, like, did you just shut it off?
No.
It took
steps. I started eating it lunchtime because they gave me time during the day to burn the meat off. And by the time I laid down, I can eat a salad or something, I can go on to bed.
And that's what our people need to know. That's what people need to know. It's a process. You don't look at somebody who's where they are right then and there and say, oh, I can't do that. No, it's a process. A lot of times people don't get the process. They just get the finished result. They don't get the process
but
of it.
But when do you get to a point where you start acting like an adult and stop saying, oh, man, I just got to eat it?
They got to want it.
You have to want to live. I want to fucking be here.
They
at the end of the day, that's the only reason. I had an ailment that I fixed by not eating meat. That I don't have to take no more medicine for it. I don't have to do none of that just by solely taking meat out of my diet. And I ain't going to I wanted the Popeye's chicken sandwich. Fuck that sandwich.
I've never had the sandwich
like,
either.
Straight up. Motherfucker stood in line all the damn day.
Is it a different kind of chicken?
I don't know. I didn't go get it. You a Popeye's
you
eater.
You had the Popeye's?
Shout out to you, Mom. She's a faithful Popeye's eater. You don't mess with Popeye's either?
Really?
And listen, and peep the marketing. They was getting bagged so much for marketing to black people. The next Popeye's commercial I seen today had white people in it. The only black person was the black lady that's always in the damn commercial.
Ooh.
Man, fuck that goddamn show, man. Like, if you want to spend that bag, Popeye, we can talk about the advertisement. But fuck
that's
you.
That's the same. I think that's the best.
Fuck them. They advertise for us, feeding us that bullshit. So shit, I take their money, and I still talk. Cause talking shit about them is advertising. That's what motherfuckers don't understand. By me just saying fuck Popeyes, that's advertisement for them.
Right.
So fuck Popeyes. Goddamn, spend that bag.
That's a shame.
Like straight up, we see y'all. Y'all look stupid as shit. Like y'all look stupid as shit. That look horrible. Listen, shout out Melanin Locks. All right, Melanin Locks.
In the house.
Y'all just don't understand. It's a whole nother work section going on. We maximizing our motherfucking income. And yeah, fuck it up. Fuck it up. Yeah, how? Fuck it up. Fuck it up. Fuck it up. Fuck it up. Y'all don't know what's going on. Fuck it up. Come on. You want to arch your back too? It's a whole twerk fest going on behind the scene. Yeah, Melanin Locks getting busy. Getting bit of ass in the camera. Ass. My man caught it. I know you caught it. My God. He looked in my face when he did it. Hit ass. I was like, Ass. All on the screen. But listen.
Can't do that with Sean, man.
Back to you. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Listen.
Not for real.
Like I was saying, Ayanna was a shock to me.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure she was a shock to everyone. So, and you know what? When I wrote the question, what was your rock bottom? Because I just think about kids.
You thought that
up.
Was...
No.
Okay.
No. I made sure I wanted to ask that question. I wanted to ask that question nowhere near this question.
Okay.
Because childbirth to me is beautiful, regardless of when it happens, how it happens. I know I said I done had 2 and 3 abortions, but God damn it, shit happens.
Right.
All
right.
Them wasn't my decisions. I wanted to have all of them.
Right.
Except for one.
You know what, I can't, regardless of whatever I think, it's real. You being like completely real. Completely real. Truth is the truth.
It's fucked up. Don't laugh because it's fucked up. I mean, but listen, I like she asked me how pretty you think you. I said I want the prettiest motherfucker to ever live. I said and I felt that shit. But at the end of the day, I would be a stereotype of a handsome young black man that had an ugly baby mama. So I kind of talked to her. I was like, yo. You should. And that changed my life because I stopped fucking ugly bitches at that point.
You took it right out of my mouth. Because I was just about to say your choices, your decisions. Yeah, I don't want to do it no more.
I was in the military. I was cutting up. I was fucking like hell. I was getting busy.
Major.
Listen, you find hoods everywhere. You feel me? And it be some good trash out there. You don't understand.
Good trash. Please break that down.
Listen, good trash.
Break that all the way down.
How you make it from make sense? You don't know what good trash?
Trash is trash.
Yeah, but you can find some good trash. Listen.
It ain't no good trash.
On that counter over there, please explain. Three books that I found.
Okay.
And it was from, I assume it was from a teacher or a principal, somebody in a leadership position. Okay. They're all leadership books. They threw them away because I guess they read them. Okay. I picked them books up. I say, this could be beneficial to my life. Good trash.
So one man's trash is another man's treasure type of trash?
Nope. Not saying that because these bitches ain't shit.
It still don't make sense.
But it's still good trash. Because listen, you understand me. You can meet a girl. You know, they say everything that glitter ain't gold.
Mm-hmm.
You can see the glitter falling off this bitch.
But glitter ain't gold. That's the thing.
Listen to me, though.
All right, I got it. Go ahead.
You can see the glitter falling off.
All right.
And she can be a perfect woman.
Mm-hmm.
But for you at that time,
right?
She may not be perfect for you.
Exactly.
She's good.
Mm-hmm.
But for your life,
right?
She's trash.
Why would she be trash? When you say she's good, Why would she be trash? Are you talking about good on the outside? Is that the type of good you're talking about?
No, I'm not saying that completely. Because you can meet him. I can meet you. Actually, you are a beautiful soul. You are a beautiful woman inside and out.
Thank you.
If we didn't know each other,
right?
I'd be trying you. Okay? Strongly. Not forcefully, because that's Me Too moments. Strongly, though. Hey.
We don't need none of those.
Hi.
Right.
How are you?
Right.
Good morning. Random messages in your inbox, shit like that.
Yeah.
Pursuing you.
Right.
But I still can have somebody.
Yeah.
But I see your worth. I see who you are. Maybe you won't be trash if I wasn't in this situation. But because I'm in this situation, you're trash for my life.
Right.
So you could be good trash. Not calling you good trash.
Oh, no, I know. I'm well aware.
You're a goddess to me. Cause honestly,
I'm well aware.
But listen, it's women in life you meet that you just don't want to fuck because you're scared you're going to mess up the purity of that woman.
Right.
And I look at you that way. Because I know I ain't hitting no shit that time. I'm working on it. I'm working on myself. But I can honestly look at you, go out with you, be in the car with you, be in the room with you, and not want to fuck because I understand your spirit and your soul and your energy.
Right.
And you don't meet people like that.
Right.
You don't.
Exactly
like,
right.
And like that's just a different vibe you get from people.
That's, yeah.
Man,
definitely.
Shout out to you.
But still, the good trash thing. I mean, you said you said it. But the good trash thing.
Still
I guess
don't understand
it's your mindset or your perspective.
Perspective, mindset,
situation.
How
you're
gonna
look of how you're deciding to look at it.
Yeah, and
you're looking at it as good trash, something that's good, but you also know that that's trash.
That's trash.
So that's your perspective.
Because it's not gonna help your life. And if you let trash, if you let trash sit around and fester, it's gonna clutter your life.
Yeah.
It's gonna make you sick. You're not gonna be able to move around like you want to because you got this clump of trash, that clump of trash. And when trash just start piling up around you, and a single person can do that to you.
Yeah, true.
They don't let you move here and move there because they don't want you to. That's not their perception of you. That's not what they want to see in you. So they try to keep you confined in this type of box that's just not you.
Right.
And you know, and that's what just trash does. Hey, I just felt like that was a bar, nigga. I don't know what y'all talking about. But anyway, bring it back to the show.
We just took a step into the reality. Sean Q on the couch.
Hey,
What it do?
Hey, listen, we're going to play the motherfucker. Listen, shout out to you for making me published again.
Oh, yeah.
So listen, play that first motherfucking video I made for the photo shoot. that we had. Run that joint. Run that joint.
Oh, yeah. It was dope.
Decide that you're going to push yourself. Most people won't do that. Most people give up on themselves easily. You know the human spirit is powerful. There's nothing as powerful. It's hard to kill the human spirit.
But you don't succeed. Dust yourself off and try again. You can dust it off and try again and try again. Cause if at first you don't succeed, you can dust it off and try again. Dust yourself off and try again and try again.
Unmute me too. I got them wagging on that goddamn video. Hey, I don't want to disrespect you. Like, I know I just said I wouldn't fuck with you.
Tread lightly.
Good God.
I didn't know.
Good God.
I didn't know.
So you don't want too many facets in life. Hey.
Praise. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. All right, I don't even know that nigga, but Jesus. I'm going to call him. Shit.
What's up?
Did you pray to Jesus or God?
I pray to God.
Oh, okay. Shout out to you.
Shout out to you. You want to go there?
We can.
Hey.
Whatever it takes, right?
Whatever it takes.
We got to fix our youth.
Whatever it takes. Jody Bean would be...
I know. That's why I hope he catch this
Jody
part.
Jody Bean would be like...
I hope he catch this part. He's in the DR right now. He's in the Dominican Republic right
now. Yeah, he's on vacation.
I hope his ass ain't getting murdered. Hey, why the fuck would you go to the DR right now?
That's why he should have Wi-Fi.
Niggas getting murdered in the DR.
Jody Bean said he a G.
Just that drink.
Drink killing, yeah.
It's the drink.
Really?
Yeah. But please don't be lying that drink.
Yeah, don't drink. Don't drink.
Okay.
It's the hotel.
Be safe. I should be safe. Hey. Definitely. Definitely be safe.
Look at that wagon.
You gotta chill on the wagon now. Okay.
You dragging it? This is the greatest relationship to base.
I'm so used to it, like I don't even know what I don't even realize.
We ain't even talked about no relationship shit. We talked about the relationship with you, with the grown ups in the goddamn community. So
yeah,
fuck it, we
that's,
fixed
that's
our
the,
obligations.
That's the major thing.
Like,
but
fuck
you,
all this dumb
you
shit.
Get off of that though. I do wanna say that we need to heal.
Keep going back. Oh,
that's,
we need to heal.
The,
what you mean
heal? Like at us as people, you know how you said that, you know, in your life, how you was like, you know, you were angry at a certain point.
Yeah.
You were mad at a certain point. A lot of people are angry and mad about many different things. You know, some more heavier than others, but it's so important for us to heal. And it's just like any other wound you have. You know, you go through a process, whether you have surgery or whether you have, you've been hurt or whatever, you take time to heal. Sometimes you gotta be out of work. Sometimes you can't be up walking around. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you can't eat certain things. It's a process that it takes for your body to heal. And that's just a physical wound. But, you know, when you go through something emotional, whether it traumatized you in any kind of way, you can't just walk on like, oh, yeah, I'm good. Ain't nothing wrong. No, address that.
And you know what?
And heal from that.
This is the thing.
And then move forward.
It took depression to hit close to me for me to understand it.
Yeah.
Because I've always been a pick yourself upper.
Yeah.
I got bullied when I was little, and I just started fighting back.
Yeah.
And it fixed it. So I was like, okay, so if I rebel against what's bothering me, it fixes the problem.
Yeah, but see, the thing of it is, we think that it fixes it, but it doesn't fix it completely. Because just like there's an African proverb that says, if there's no enemy within, there's no enemy without. So if you address what triggered you on the inside of you, you can't be triggered again.
No, but what if it's a motherfucker fucking with me is what triggered
me? I mean, you got to handle your business then.
Okay.
But at the same time, you got to, kind of like that movie Karate Kid with Mr. Miyagi.
Yeah.
Mr. Miyagi, you had to really push Mr. Miyagi for him to fight. You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't easy.
I'm
like,
too
some
little
people
for that.
So easy to pop off. Like, we gotta reassess the way we react. And Nipsey Hussle said that.
Yeah, that's and big facts. Shout out.
Yeah.
R.I.P. Nip. R.I.P. Nip.
Right.
R.I.P. Scrap. R.I.P. Andrew Johnson. We gonna keep saying it. But I feel that. But this is the problem with I gonna say this is a problem. This is what I went through when I was young.
Right.
So we, I want to tell y'all to put down the guns. I want to tell you that. But in my mind, if I tell you that, I know that can get you murdered.
True.
Because everybody is not hearing my message. Mm-hmm. So I want to say get a gun legally while you still can. But it's, I don't want to deliver that message to my youth.
Right.
I'm, this is a cycle that I'm caught in trying to help them. And the only thing I can think of to get them out of the, is to fix it, is to get them out of the environment completely. But I can't let everybody come live with me.
And I'm going to say something, and I really hope people get this. A lot of people leave, and in your live, you said, you know, F. Chester.
I'm going to fix that.
I'm going to say this.
I want to say fuck Chester, but fuck the mentality of Chester. Let me say that. Fuck the mentality of Chester. Because I can't say fuck it because that's what made me. And if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be thinking like this now. So I can't say fuck Chester, but I can say fuck the mentality of Chester because that shit is detrimental. I feel bad when I go to Chester.
I can agree with that.
I see going down Rocky Hill Road, that little sign that be on the right, welcome Chester County. Soon as I cross that shit, like you can feel.
You know you're not the only person who said that. Like people say that.
Like it's something, the roots down there. I think the motherfuckers in Rocky Hill, right? Them roots down there, Chester, goddamn. Them goddamn roots down there, boy.
No, but my thing is, if everybody leaves, if everyone leaves, who's there to stay and to help change it? You know, not everybody. It's like you can lead a horse to the water, but you can't make it drink.
I mean, there's people there. You got people like Coach Graham. Like, if it weren't for Coach Graham, I know I'd be dead in jail.
But you need more than... We need as many people as we can get. It takes a village to raise a child.
We can't just not holler at the people that's doing it. Because there's a lot of people that are at Corey Land. Right.
Corey is doing an amazing job. Yeah,
he went to Great Falls. It's an extension to Chester.
I'm very proud of
you know,
Corey.
And he coaching up there and he helping. And I know that brother's mentality. So I know he's leading them boys in the right direction.
Right.
Like, there's people out there that's doing it, so I really don't want to leave those people out when we just, you know, I don't want to just bash and say ain't nobody doing that, because there's people out there that's working. Yeah.
And it takes time for Marcus Tolliver,
even though you ain't shit, but Marcus Tolliver.
I didn't agree with that when I said
that's my
now,
friend. I can say that.
For that
that's
right
my
there,
friend. Hey, listen, he know how I feel.
Marcus, you cool with
but
me?
But he do good in the community. He does do a lot of good in the community. But
he does.
With me, you ain't shit. With me.
I don't know what that's about.
Sound
like
with
personal.
It's personal. It's personal. Some number. But with me, he ain't shit. But with everybody, with the community, and what he's doing with his outreach, he show up. I cannot like the person
out.
And respect
He'll speak
your work.
Out on anything.
Like facts, I cannot like the person and respect your work.
That's
so
good.
You know, at the end of the day, fuck you.
At the beginning of a new day. I got you, Marcus. I got you.
Oh shit! But nah, that's my dude, man. We grew up together. We've had a long lasting relationship, so I can talk about him like that.
Right.
But yeah,
he probably laughing like crazy.
That's on Amazon, people.
Yeah, cop that.
It's
Amazon.
On Amazon.
Or directly from me at the Sip 6, October 5th.
You know how you put a motherfucker on the hot seat. So listen, when you know go buy this book, I'm pretty sure it's gonna go to a good cause.
Yeah.
It could be to help one of your little fuck ass kids. Like, listen, you know your child bad as fuck. You understand? You know he out there doing a lot of shit that you don't approve of. So listen, sometimes you just gotta... I'm gonna put your book down. I don't even want that to be a part of your message. You just gotta...
It speaks for itself.
Like, yeah, you just gotta lead your... like, you know!
Yeah, when they say it starts at home,
like you know.
I know we hear that all the time. It starts at home. But no, literally, it starts at home. Like, one thing that I was looking forward to coming here and talking is because a lot of people don't you know, I don't talk to a lot of people.
Yeah.
Especially not open and you know, like this, because a lot of people ain't hitting on that. And I'm going to say that.
I
love
that.
People. Oh, yeah. Be cool. I love people. Don't get me wrong. I have love for people because I understand the bigger picture. It's bigger than us. And a lot of us don't even know where we come from. And someone told me that you have to understand where you come from to know where you're headed. It's a lot of people out here who don't have any identity. And I'm not talking about your Facebook profile. I'm not talking about your driver's license or your ID at the DMV. I'm not talking about that.
That is your
identity. I'm talking about not that. I'm talking about where we come from, like our ancestors. You have to understand your place. You have to understand your place when you were born into this world. It's like a race when somebody passed the baton. Like somebody dropped that a couple times.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? when I wake up, when I think about, you know, something that I don't feel like doing, because I can't sit up here and say that I'm motivated and I'm encouraged all the time, every day. I try my best to stay in that energy, and I surround myself with positivity, whether that's listening to something motivational or surrounding myself with my friend girls who are very motivational. They have a major impact on my life. Shout out to One Impact, Myra, my homegirl, who also is the owner of Melody Glow.
Shout out to Myra. Go ahead,
yeah, she's doing her thing. And, you know, you really have to understand that gives you purpose. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are like, well, what is my purpose? What is my purpose? The fact that you are alive, you can continue the legacy. It's not just about you. It's not just about your family and your household. It's not just about the family that, you know, y'all come together for your family reunion. It's about all of us. That those marches that, you know, Martin Luther King held and participated. I mean, those things, it's about all of us. We got to continue that legacy. We got to continue forward.
This is my problem with that. This is my only problem with that. Because sometimes who you hang around just makes you. I ain't gonna say sometimes. Who you hang around makes you who you are.
Yeah.
So true. That's why, like, listen, I'm gonna be honest. When I met my homeboy Ren, I saw he was a fucking nerd.
Right.
I saw it. But also, I also saw that he was still a genuine person.
Right.
And with me just latching on to him just being a natural, genuine person, right. I got to see his lifestyle.
Right.
That I would have never saw if I wouldn't have befriended a nerd.
True.
You feel me? So, y'all stupid.
It makes you well-rounded.
Yeah, and the people that I met, and I tell them all the time, bro, like, I love you for the people you put me around.
Right.
Like, and I don't meet them people and grab from them. I just soak up the energy that they put off.
Right.
Because they're successful people.
And you're supposed to.
And my friends don't know them type of people. Mm-mm. And just by the fact, man, I'm going to tell you this. I thought when I was driving trucks, I thought I had a good fucking job. I'm making good fucking money. And I was sitting around one of his homegirls and shit. And she's like, hey, what do you do? I was on my truck driver. She's like, ew. In my mind, bitch. That's what I said in my mind. But I had to think from a different perspective. Y'all stupid.
No, I'm saying like
in my, yeah, that was fucked. She said ill. She literally said ill. And her brother was like, hey.
Out loud, like, yeah. She was like, face, ew. Like, ew.
I didn't get mad though, because I had to think from her perspective. Good. From her perspective, driving a fucking truck
all day.
Were
you insulted?
No. Because I think I'm too smart to be a truck driver. I say that all the time. I think that I'm too smart to do this route every day. It makes good fucking money. I'm not going to say that it doesn't. But me personally, I think I'm too smart for that. I can be doing so much more.
Right.
So I didn't get offended when she said it. It opened me up, like, so to other people, that's ill too.
Right.
It's not a bitch. I said bitch in my mind. No lie. And I'm trying to stop saying bitch. But bitch.
How many times you done said it? Bitch. Already?
Listen, in my mind, I was like, bitch. But then I had to think, like, okay, why did she say that? Right. Why did she say ill?
Right.
Because, like, that's manual labor to her. Mm-hmm. And I'm not about to fucking get in no truck. Why would I do that? Mm. When I know I can go sit here and either talk on the phone or have a negotiation with you or sell something that's completely valuable and I can make 10 times more what you're doing. So, yeah, ill.
But let me follow me. Come with me on this now.
Okay.
Everybody's level or definition of success is different. Completely different.
And that's what I'm explaining.
So her ill
that's what I'm
is
explaining.
Somebody's.
But you can't look at that ill as a okay, what I'm doing ain't worth shit. Yeah.
Right.
Because I didn't get offended. Right. I got motivated. Because I got to figure out why she said ill.
Yeah.
Okay, you said ill because you wouldn't do this. Okay, why wouldn't you do it?
Right.
Oh, because you can do this and make this.
Right.
So yeah, I still drive that truck, but I took my ass to real estate school.
Right.
Because I look good when I put a motherfucking suit on.
Y'all seen that live?
Hey!
Y'all seen that live?
Hey, I look good. And I want to walk around like that. I felt I was gliding on them goddamn Steve Madden.
Get smooth on them.
Gliding on them motherfucking Steve Madden.
Skate on them, Sean.
Come on, just get me over here.
Skate on them. Get smooth.
Yeah, all that. My LL. The lips and shit. I felt like I was gliding in them Steve Madden. You hear me the other day? I went on them interviews, and both of them wanted me.
All y'all boys in the hood, that's how I feel when you put a suit on.
Put a suit on.
Get it from Sean.
And I ain't even put no tie on. With I had the collar open. If I had the tat showing. You know, I got my tat. I had the tat showing. No taco meat. No taco meat. And they still wanted the boy. Because I was original. I was myself.
That's right. I was myself. With it.
But yeah, you got to want more.
Like, don't be comfortable in who you are and what you at, because you can always be better. You can always learn
think
something more.
Think outside of the box.
More. I got to speak. Think outside of the box. You see, I'm drinking wine. At an 18-year-old Sean, I wasn't drinking no wine unless I was stealing it from my mama's cabinet, and then I didn't want it. I just wanted to get a little tip.
Right.
But now I sip. Bring this camera over here so she can walk through. Fuck it, put it back on her ass. Is it going dead? Oh,
right.
Look there. This camera show my smile mode. Oh. Couch Talk back, people. Hey, listen, we back. I know we had a long layoff. Listen, the Queen City Awards is going on right now. I know Two Dirty Minds up for, I think they nominated. No Advisory Podcast. Shit, who else? I don't know. The one I thought was nominated, not nominated. But hey, listen, go vote for a podcast. Nominate Couch Talk Podcast. I know we've been off for a minute, but shit, y'all know how y'all rock with us, because we get it in. I know with the day we took a completely different turn with what we usually talk about, but that shit was dope.
Very.
Shit was dope. I don't even know how long we've been on.
How long?
Hour and 13. You want to push to an hour and a half? We having a good conversation. Like, it's just fun. Like, I like having conversations like this to where it's cool. So, listen, we back live again. And we just gonna run it. Couch Talk Podcast. All that. Two times on Saturdays. We're gonna run on Saturdays now, because I think I can catch y'all better on Saturday when y'all a little tip. Y'all drink with the boy. Yeah, straight like that. All that.
Definitely.
So while we talking and bullshit right now, go ahead and play that other video real quick that we did for Iyshaa.
Another one?
Yeah, we did. You know we
and
did, too.
And my DJ Khaled? Another one.
Like, straight like that. It's right beside the other one. Yeah, that one. Mute one.
You love it how I move you. You love it how I touch you, my one. When all is said and done, you will believe God is a woman. And I feel it after midnight, a feeling that you can't fight, my one. It lingers when we're done, you will believe God is a woman.
Hey, had you looking like a goddess at the end of that motherfucker. Hey, I was trying my best to get, when I was editing it, I was like, I gotta find a god level type shit. How can I get
right?
I found that right motherfucking boom. I said, oh yeah, that did.
It was
that
nice.
Did it. Hey, so listen. So if you are writing a book, if you are, you know, doing anything media wise, and you need some video editing, at Sean Q Pix on, you know. My cameraman, my engineer dipped off on me.
I mean,
hey,
like,
throw that Instagram up.
Ran off on the plug.
Ran off on the plug twice. At Sean Q Pix, you know, so the people can see it. But yeah, if you need any video work, all videos except the project piece and the Joey Vandal airplane video, I didn't do those. But every other video you saw today, I personally did those, Thousand Word Productions. Couch Talk Podcast is now a extension of Thousand Word Productions. And you know, we producing shows, we doing commercials, we photo shoots, video shoots. Now, whatever you got going on media wise, you can holler at 1000 Word Productions to help you with that.
Definitely.
Your boy personally. But yeah, that's my little shameless plug for the show.
All right.
You can get whatever it takes.
That's right. And I want to say thank you to everyone who has purchased whatever it takes. I have gotten a lot of feedback. People have been sending me messages. They have been, you know, expressing their take from the book. And I'm not going to give it away. You got to get your copy.
Hold up. Let me say something.
Go ahead.
Don't ask for no motherfucking discount on the book either. Hey, listen, G-Shit, we got to get out of that mentality of, oh, just because you black, you got to give me a discount. Respect. Nah, motherfucker, pay me full price. Just because I'm black. Because you know I'm struggling. You know how hard it was to put this shit together. So pay me full price.
Amen.
Don't pay me no. We can discount next time. We can talk about discount next time. And if you got something going on, guarantee, guess what? I'm going to pay you full price, motherfucker. All right? So let's stop that discount shit, please. You're going to pay full price. How much the book cost?
$12.99.
$12.99? Yes. You're going to pay all $12.99 for this motherfucker plus the tax. Like, straight up, like, stop the discount shit. Please, as black people, stop the discount shit. Because if you don't pay us what we're worth, who the fuck will?
Right.
All right, like, stop. I'm not giving them a fucking discount. If I give you a discount, it's because I want to. I give new customer discounts because you came along. You know, I might even give you pro bono.
All right, now.
Pro bono. No, I'm not a lawyer, but I can execute some shit. Very judicial. You know what I mean? And I'm just saying. But no, that's just my, like, stop with the discounts. That's right. All. Like, let's just stop with that. Okay.
But, like I was saying, I do want to say thank you. Sincerely, I do. I appreciate all the love, all
the
support.
If you pay full price, thank you.
Yes. I appreciate all the love and the support and going forward. Now, I really, really want people to get the message that no matter what you're doing, whether you are starting a business, running a business, whether you're writing a book, whether you're just trying to find a job, just something, the simplest things, just do whatever it takes to keep moving forward. Whether you have, you know, you have your family in your ear, or you feel like you just can't do it, you just can't get it done, you got to keep pushing. You got to keep moving. Anything is possible. You know, just like the creator, everything was created. The creator had to do something to create it. What makes you think you don't have to do anything? It's like, grind time.
I like how you're saying the
it's
creator,
grind
too.
Time. You gotta do it. People saying, okay, a change. You are it. You're it. Come on, we waiting on you. We need all of us, period. You can't just say, well, so-and-so ain't helped me. So-and-so ain't give me this.
Ain't
so-and-so
no
ain't do this.
Oh, my God. Can I
we
speak
waiting
on that?
You.
Can
speak
I speak
on
that?
It.
Like,
speak
listen,
on it.
I was a spoiled-ass little kid growing up. I was the baby on my mama's side, and I was the oldest on my daddy's side. You feel me? So I was spoiled as shit. Like, I literally got what I wanted. I literally got what I wanted. So when I graduated, I was looking for somebody to tell me what's next to do. Because I didn't know.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't, and even when I went to the military, I went to the military because they told me what to do every fucking day.
Right.
6 o'clock, you're going to do this. 8 o'clock, you'll be here. 12 o'clock, you're going to be here. 1 o'clock, yeah, boom, boom. They had my day mapped out for me.
Yeah.
And in the military is when I really started thinking, like, wait the fuck a minute.
Yeah.
I'm not living.
Right.
I'm a robot because they're literally telling me everything that I'm doing.
You're taking orders.
Kimmy Casey, she need a copy. We're going to get you. Matter of fact.
Yeah.
I got you.
Definitely.
I'm going to do a raffle or something. I'm going to figure it out. I tell you, this is what I do. For if you're watching right now,
right.
If you can tell me the episode number of the infamous fight, I'll give you a free copy of Whatever It Takes. If you can tell me the episode of the, if you can tell me the episode number
right.
of the infamous fight, I'll give you a free copy of Whatever It Takes. I understand what you said. Listen, this is my house episode. That's the
right.
name of the episode. But if you can tell me the episode number, I'll give you a free copy of Whatever It Takes.
That's major. You know how many people probably gonna get that right? You think they're gonna get it
the
right?
The first person, you better tell me first. Everything you send me on Facebook is timestamped.
Right.
So, the first person to send me the episode number, you get a free copy of Whatever It Takes.
That's major.
Boom.
Y'all better tell them what episode it is.
Sure.
You
what that is.
You hey. Know that.
What that is. Hey. And listen, this table. Choo, 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 choo.
I was watching that the other day when I say dump fire.
That hey. So, what were we talking about? I'm sorry. Oh, we were doing promo.
Right. Exactly.
Okay, so listen, let me.
Oh, yeah, I want to shout out the logo. I had this idea for Whatever It Takes, which we are still in the making.
Exclusive!
There will be t-shirts available. I'm just now announcing it.
Exclusive!
Not many people know about it. So I want to give a shout out to Kid Dip.
Whoop, whoop!
Boy Dip.
Kid Dip.
I had the vision and I tossed it to Kid Dip and he brought it to life. I want to give a shout out to Rod. Rod also do tattoos. Kid Dip got his album out right too.
Yeah.
Check that out.
Oh,
check
that's
it out.
On iTunes.
Right. Shout out to.
They got that single Gelato.
Right.
Name of the album is Legend. Legend. Legend's the album. It's yeah. on iTunes. Gelato was their hit single. I fucked with Gelato. That's a good song. It was funny because I was fucking right and I was like, you know who that is? You know who that is?
Yes, shout out to Dip. Go check out his album. And another shout out to Rod. Rod actually got the shirt together for me. He also does tattoos, so if you need some ink, holla at Rod.
How the hell we know who the hell, how we get in touch with Rod?
Through Facebook.
What's his name on Facebook?
Rod.
Just Rod.
Let me see. I got to check. All right,
you can't be telling motherfuckers, go holla at Rod. How the fuck we going to get to Rod? Like, we know Kid Dip a little bit.
Dip. I'm about to tell you who Rod is.
Just Rod, holler at Rod.
Yeah, go Rod.
But nah, let me while she's looking that up, let me go to that next week, because we're coming right back with y'all next week. We got off
Rod Kowser.
Rod Kowser?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to hold on to Rod for a second. We're going to hold on to Rod for a second. Off Top K Trill, the blue one with the jersey, with the jersey on. We're going Off Top K Trill will be here next week. We're going to discuss a lot. A lot been going on with him, his camp, and everything going on. And the week after that, we got my boy, all the videos you've seen today, my main man, Airplane, Joey Vandal on Facebook. That's who we got the week after that. So listen, Couch Talk is back, full effect. Listen, y'all just got to rock with the camp.
Yeah.
We ain't going to leave y'all no more. We ain't going to leave y'all no more. I understand.
You got to make it a movement.
It's a movement. You already
it's like whatever
know.
It takes. You got to do whatever it takes. He ain't gonna leave you no more.
Still want my shirt,
bro. I'm gonna get you your Couch Talk shirt. Merchandise is coming and all that.
That's right.
So, yeah, that's what we got going on with Couch Talk. Listen, available on Amazon right now. Whatever it takes. Which camera you got me in? Front one. All right, boom. Whatever it takes right now, you can cop that joint on Amazon.
Yes.
I had my sister Iyshaa Wilks come through and get y'all a bomb ass show. Listen, I really want to talk some more. But we would have started talking about them other topics. We would have never ended the show.
Man.
That's why I didn't even.
To be continued.
Yeah, to be continued. You come back? You gonna come back?
Who knows? We'll see.
You're supposed to say yeah. Fuck you too.
Yeah.
Anyway, listen.
He gonna make me get hood on. He know I've been keeping it cool.
Yeah, I see. You've been. Hey, listen. You've been giving some real media, like you know what you're doing answers.
Yeah.
Cause I asked you one question. I was like, wow.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm ready.
That was a dope ass. We were talking about the abortion. That was a dope ass answer. But anyway,
yeah.
We'd like to thank y'all for tuning
thank
in
you.
To another episode of Couch Talk
yes.
podcast. So listen, you can follow us on Instagram at couch_talk_. You can follow me at Sean Q Pix on Instagram. Really, you can follow me at Sean Q Pix everywhere. You can follow my sister on Instagram at d.aisha.
Right.
And you can go get Whatever It Takes on Amazon. Listen, support. Because right. The only way we can make a change, if you see the mentality is to make a change, the only way we can make a change is that money. So you
right.
got to spend it some way in form or fashion. Like, you're going to spend it on the club. You're going to spend it on weed. You're going to spend it on twerking and dumb shit. Like, spending it on the movement is going to help your kids.
Right.
Like, some of you bitches ain't hitting on shit. But some of y'all are really out here trying.
We almost made it out. Like, almost. It was, like, epic. I was so proud of you. I was rooting for you on the inside. Like, yeah.
But listen, I want to finish. Some of you niggas ain't hitting on shit. So, like, stop being fuck-ass people. All right? And do whatever it takes to get yourself out of that position and into a better one.
Major.
If it's changing the people you're around, do that.
Don't be afraid to change.
If it's changing your environment, do that. If you hate your fucking job, go do something that makes you happy.
Right.
At the end of the day, be who you want to be and do whatever it takes.
That's it.
To get yourself to the next level. Thank you, Iyshaa.
You're welcome.
Come fuck the handshake. Bring your ass here.
Got you.
All that. But listen, thank y'all for tuning in to another episode of Couch Talk, and we out this bitch. Good night. You don't know how to stop it, do you? Just hit the stop button.